हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू क्रिएटिव मेडिसिन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस नाउ लर्न सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स अबाउट द डाइगैस्ट्रिक और सब मैंडिबुलर ट्रायंगल। इफ यू सी, दिस इज द मास्टॉइड प्रोसेस, दिस इज द एंकल ऑफ मैंडिबल, ओके, दिस इज द हायोइड बोन। सो डाइगैस्ट्रिक ट्रायंगल इज फॉर्म्ड बाय मेनली डाइगैस्ट्रिक मसल। सो पोस्टरो इंफीरियर टू दैट ऑफ डाइगैस्ट्रिक ट्रायंगल वी हैव this posterior valley of digastric, anterior inferiorly to this digastric triangle we have anterior valley of digastric, and base is lined by the mandible and the imaginary line which is joining the mandible and the mastoid process. So base is formed by the mandible and an imaginary line joining the mandible and mastoid process. So this is anterior inferiorly. You can see anterior belly of digastric, and here you can see postero inferiorly, which is again posterior belly of digastric. Anterior inferiorly, you can see anterior belly of digastric. Posterior inferiorly, posterior belly of digastric. Then base, you can see it is formed by the mandible, base of mandible, and the imaginary line which is joining the mandible with the mastoid process. Right, roof is formed by the deep fascia, that is investing layer of deep cervical fascia. Then what about the floor? Floor is formed by mainly three muscles. First muscle, second and third. Okay, so let me name them. So the first muscle here is this one. Okay, this floor is formed by the mylohyoid muscle. This is mylohyoid. Okay, the floor is also formed by the second muscle. This is the second muscle which forms the floor of the digastric triangle, which is formed by hyoglossus, and this is the fourth which is formed by the sorry third muscle which is formed by the middle constrictor of pharynx. It is formed by middle constrictor of pharynx. So the submandibular triangle is formed by the base of the submandibular and digastric triangle is formed by mylohyoid muscle, hyoglossus muscle, and middle constrictor of pharynx. So this digastric triangle is the most common site for the swelling involving submandibular gland. Why? Because submandibular gland is situated in this triangle. So let me draw the contents of the digastric triangle. So this I'll draw a little bigger, and this is the mastoid process. Okay, and this is the hyoid bone. Right, now first we will draw the muscles, also the boundaries. Anterior inferiorly, it is formed by anterior belly of digastric. Posterior inferiorly, it is formed by posterior belly of digastric. Base is formed by the angle of mandible and the imaginary line which is joining the mastoid process and angle of mandible. In this we have one most important structure, which is the submandibular gland. So here you will see the presence of submandibular gland. So this is the submandibular gland. So in this submandibular gland, this based on the submandibular gland, you can either divide those contents which are in the anterior part of the triangle, those contents which are in the posterior part of the triangle. So this is the submandibular gland. Okay, along with submandibular gland, we have other structures, like we have the facial artery. Okay, which you can see here. Okay, this facial artery will have a rounded course like this. Okay, and it gets inserted into the external carotid artery. This is the carotid, which is dividing into external carotid and internal carotid. Okay, right. Now these external and internal carotid arteries also go into the some part of posterior part of the triangle. In the posterior part of the triangle, you can see the external carotid artery and internal carotid artery which are going on. Then if you see, you have vein, facial vein is present in the anterior part of the triangle. Internal jugular vein is present in the posterior part of the triangle. Here you can see the internal jugular vein. Okay, then if you see in the anterior part of the triangle, you have the submandibular lymph nodes are also seen in the anterior part of the triangle here. So these are the sites of, these are the three things, facial, see, let me write it. These are the three things which are important. You will see the presence of facial vein, this is facial artery, and obviously this is submandibular lymph nodes. Okay, and this is submandibular gland. Right, these are seen in the anterior part of the triangle, and we also have smaller branches of myelohyoid nerves and vessels are also seen here. A small branch of myelohyoid nerves and vessels are also seen. So this is myelohyoid nerves and vessels. And one more important thing which you see, one of the cranial nerve, which is hypoglossal nerve, is seen in the anterior part of the triangle. So this is how you see the hypoglossal nerve, which is seen in the anterior part of the triangle. It goes out like this. You do not need to know the course, just you should identify it. That is important. So this is hypoglossal triangle, which are seen in the anterior part of the digastric triangle. Then if you see the posterior part of the digastric triangle, in the posterior part we have, this is external carotid artery, this is internal carotid artery, we have internal jugular vein. Okay, then we have three main three of the muscles which are derived from the styloid process. If this is the mandible, then if this is the mastoid process, then here somewhere you will have the styloid process. Okay, let me just draw the, highlight the styloid process. So this is the styloid process. Now connecting to the styloid process, we have three muscles, that is stylohyoid. First we have stylopharyngeus, which is connecting the styloid process to the pharyngeal muscles. Then we have styloglossus, from styloid process to the tongue. And we have stylohyoid, styloid process to the hyoid bone. Okay, so these three muscles are also present in the posterior triangle. And one vein, one nerve which is very important is vagus nerve. Okay, we have this vagus nerve also seen in the posterior part of the triangle. So in the posterior part of the triangle, we have one more vagus nerve. Then these muscles, which is stylopharyngeus first. Then this is styloglossus. This is stylohyoid. Okay, so these are the contents of the posterior part of triangle, and these are the contents in the anterior part of the triangle. So this is about the digastric triangle. Thank you guys for watching my lecture. Thank you.
Thank you, and thank you for watching.